Previously on Getting to Know Dreamcatcher.
Oh, this is hot rock here. Hello.
Oh yeah, this one goes really hard.
Okay, I didn't expect that at all. Okay, that gave me shivers. Like, okay.
I know. That transition was so good.
Yeah, the transition's great. Huh? Okay, I feel like I'm either dumb or I missed something. What? No, I thought I understood everything, but no, apparently I didn't understand anything. Okay. It's going to be the start, finally, of the
Dystopian Trilogy! Let's
yes! Go! The trilogy that is very, very lit. Misaki here, along with Ruka!
Hello!
And I'm not sure if this is the finale, but who knows, but...
It's probably not the finale, because we've got... There is a couple stuff after this, actually, after this trilogy.
Okay,
but
great.
Yes, the Dystopian Trilogy, yes. Right here!
Yes, excited for this so long, because actually all the songs.
I for one am hyped up for this because this was like, it's not the first comeback I experienced with Dreamcatcher, but it was my first comeback after I started really deep diving into K-pop and really started my journey into becoming a full-fledged insomnia. Because I think I might have mentioned it before in, you know, some other videos that I've worked on with you, but I started out as a casual fan of Dreamcatcher. I started out as a casual listener.
Yes, yeah.
But after I started deep diving and getting more into K-pop, I really decided to, like, deep dive more into Dreamcatcher and really become a fan of theirs and Insomnia.
Right.
So, like, the Dystopia Trilogy was what helped me on that journey to becoming...
Aww.
Full-fledged insomnia that I am today.
Oh, so I'm just going through with you, your little nostalgia trip, basically.
Yeah.
Oh, but yeah, similar, not really, but like when I started becoming a proper K-pop stan, I think this was the trilogy that was made known to me quite often, especially Scream. Because I think it was
during
a time where it was during Luna's So What promotions, I think.
Yeah,
so I guess it coincided, and then I was like, oh, Scream, okay. And then before I react to it, I'm just gonna say, listen to all of the trilogy songs, I actually love them now. But back then I wasn't too I don't know, I didn't really vibe with Scream, but after a few listens, I don't know, it just came to me, I'm like, wait, why did I think this song wasn't my type? It's so good! Yeah, so, as for the MV, I don't think I've watched it, other than like some clips of like masks and stuff. I think they were masks.
Masks are, it's an important part of this because it's very important to the overall theme of the Dystopia story.
Masks. Okay, why?
So the whole theme of the Dystopia Trilogy that you'll see in all three music videos, and if you look at the lyrics, you'll see them in the lyrics. The entire theme of the Dystopia Trilogy is basically the toxic side of social media. So it talks about online hate, cyberbullying, the anonymous hater. Yeah, it talks about all that kind of stuff, all those kind of societal issues revolving around internet and the social media and stuff like that. Yeah.
Wait, wow. I didn't know they tackled this topic in this trilogy.
Oh yeah, they did. They did.
Well, I'm even more excited to listen to it. Okay. Listen and watch. I've listened to it a lot of times, it's just that I haven't watched it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We'll just go into Scream now.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, starting off, we'll talk about this opening shot so you can read right here what it says. Dramatically, yes.
One day, suddenly the light did not come. People forgot how to say good things.
Oh, okay, that's it. Is that it?
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh yeah, it's just like purple hair. Like
purple
you mentioned.
Hair too, yeah. Yes! It's such an iconic look.
Oh wow, the clouds at the back, the green.
I know.
Wow. Wow, okay. Hey, they have dancers now.
Oh yeah, they have dancers.
Interesting, okay, she's running away.
But yeah, by the way, you'll see too in the dance shots, they have a masked dancer with the girls. Mm. That's meant to represent Hangdong.
Ah, okay. Oh, the one at the back, I see.
Yeah.
Look, wow, okay. Mask girl gets her screen time. Oh.
I'm like doing the choreo along with it. It's so good!
Oh, wow. It feels like a while since I've listened to this song. Yes! Oh wait, she's the one who raps? I thought it was Dami the whole time. Well,
Dami's the main rapper, but Gahyeon's the lead rapper.
He's rapped in a couple, especially their later
releases. Do you remember after PD, she had a rap part in PD.
Yes, just that. I thought the whole part was Dami. I didn't know it was Gahyeon too. Oh, those blocks look like, you know, database.
Right.
The CG is so good in this. It's like watching a movie, a proper movie.
Right, the budget for this is insane.
So good. Wow. Oh wow. And their outfits are really pretty too. Yes, to be continued. Yes, we know. That was good. Wow! But now with context.
Yeah, putting in a bit more context for this as well. So you see, like, the tree is a very prominent image in the music video too.
I noticed that tree.
Yeah. A tree, it's known as the Tree of Language, which was also the name of their first full album, which Scream was released on, the Tree of Language. So what they explain kind of the story behind it, is that with the tree, when people say good things, it bears white fruit, but when people say bad things, it bears black fruit. And so one day, when the light disappears and people forget how to say good things, it starts to grow more and more black fruit and become overrun with this negative energy.
Yes, yeah. It's to represent darkness, basically, right? Wow.
And you'll see it. One thing I really like about this is that going through each music video, they're sort of in different time eras.
Oh, really? Okay. So this one was basically medieval. It felt very medieval.
It felt like a witch hunt, basically, where like the girls were witches using magic. Mm. And so this one with BOCA is definitely more of a modern setting.
Oh, okay. More modern stuff. All right. But yes, BOCA. I'm aware of this. You probably have heard of me being aware of this in previous videos. So yeah, mm-hmm. We're gonna get into it. And we have like a pretty shot of the tree again. Tree mm-hmm. that says part 2 dystopia lost. Sorry, it's not lost.
Lose right? Myself. Lose that myself. Was the name of the mini album yes. This was on. Lose Myself.
Yes. Clearly I couldn't see it properly, but I okay. Now we shall pray. August. Yes, I remember this song too. yes.
Pink hair guy with the space buns. This was a look too. This looks so good on her.
Okay, yeah, the lyrics are like very obviously talking about social media if you think about it. I always wondered what it meant, but now it kind of makes sense now. I thought it was nonsense, but apparently not. Wow. Oh yeah, this slow emotional part is kind of like the deja vu-ish vibe, which I like. Oh wow, thanks for giving me the context, man. Now it's like, oh wow, actually it makes sense whatever they're saying. Wow, she's rapping a lot in this trilogy.
Yeah, lead rapper Gahyeon.
Wow. I love her tone. So good. Wow. Again, super gorgeous. Like the sets are wow. They look so pretty in their dresses, by the way. And then you have this edgy cause. Oh, she shot.
A bow and arrow.
What did she shoot at? Huh? Your precious time with it. Yeah. Oh, wait. Don't tell me the arrow shot at her. What? Too many angels dying now. Oh yeah, this high note, man. Wow. Iconic.
Iconic!
Ooh. Oh, the mask again. Wait, I just realized. Oh! This BOCA still didn't have one of the members, right?
Right, Hanbong.
Yeah, she's still not back yet.
Right, but luckily she came back late 2020 after BOCA era had ended and she was able to make it for Odd Eye. Like, when they did their first live performance where they performed BOCA and Scream for the first time with Hangdong, that was awesome.
Yeah, of course. I mean, also for the fans, everyone must have been like, you know, super excited to see everyone back again. Of course. Yeah, it does have the Alone in the City vibes, and it's more pronounced in the sense where they actually tackle the you know, the whole societal issue in that.
Yeah.
It's like a lot more obvious in the lyrics compared to Scream for me.
Like the line where Suga says too many angels dying now, and you see the shot of it's actually Yoohyeon who's holding the bow and arrow that she shoots up in the sky, but it hits herself.
Yeah, it hits her.
It shoots herself, so like you can obviously relate that to like people who hurt themselves because of they've dealt with cyberbullying or hateful words. Like it is very impactful, very emotional.
I didn't know or I didn't really look into the lyrics until today, so wow, I have a different appreciation of BOCA now. But yeah, it's a very good song. And now we will move to Odai, which is one of my favorite songs this year. Oh yes, thank goodness it's this year. This year. So good.
Yeah, this year.
Very, very good song. MV, yes, I know about the flippy part. I'm ready for that. The kicky part.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Okay. Not to spoil too much, but going into Odai of 2021. Modern day Dreamcatcher. Why is there no audio? Is it not supposed to have any audio?
Give it a minute.
Okay, I'll die. Alright. Yes. Ah, yes.
There we go.
Yes, 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 yes. And yes, can we appreciate their leather outfits? Yes.
Yes. Handong! Handong!
Ah, yes, yes, yes. Yes, yeah, yes! This verse is everything. This pre-chorus, sorry. This pre-chorus.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh my goodness. Something about lies and stuff. Oh, the tree again at the back. It's kind of dead-ish. Wow. Ah, yeah, more imagery. I think they're holding smartphones, I just realized.
Yeah.
Right.
Again, thinking about technology, social media.
Yeah. Yeah, see about lies. Oh, and then are those words on her face just now? I didn't notice.
It's like glyphs or something.
Okay, drinking poison, maybe. No? Wait, do they have different eye colors? Like different eye contacts?
Yeah, odd eye, the different colored eyes.
Oh, so everyone has an odd eye? Look, This sounds like a very strange topic to talk about, but like, oh, okay, cool. Wow. Oh, I love the bridge a lot.
Yeah, the bridge is so good.
Yeah, the bridge. Oh wow, yeah. Like the database is crashing. Yes. Oh, that's so pretty, that CG. Yes, the kicking scene. Yes. That was so good. Okay. Yeah. Ooh. Wow.
Read the end, Harry, before it ends.
In the end, the dream catchers couldn't find a utopia. What did dream the- wait, the grammar's wrong, I can't- I can't continue with like my voice, what? That broke the immersion, man, I'm sorry. Come on! Back grammar check! Dreamcatcher company! Grammar check! Please! No! Let me try that.
You know what? It's okay. It's just a minor slip up, but it's okay.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. I mean, it makes sense. Yeah. It means they couldn't find the utopia that they dreamed of. Right. Yeah.
This whole mini album, actually, that I was released on, it was called Road to Utopia.
This one. So the one that housed Odai, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. Now that I've watched everything and listened to everything with context for once. So, yeah, I have a different appreciation of it for sure. I did not know that this was kind of tackling the whole cyberbullying, bad comments, negativity aspect of internet and whatever, cancel culture, blah blah. So, wow. Impressive. I can only
I know.
So basically, because doesn't tackle anything like this, right?
No, yeah, because is its own standalone story. And so after this would be Eclipse, and I think I told you already, they did a music video for No More, which was like, they released it as a single before Eclipse came out. It was like, it was used as a B-side for Eclipse, and so there's a music video for No More. Which is, it feels very much like an AMV.
Haven't heard that in a while. But yeah,
it's like, in terms of like their like title tracks, official music videos, there's really only two left, No More and Eclipse.
Wow, we're almost there. We've almost cleared most of the grounds, or all of the grounds for Dreamcatcher. Mm. But yes, I, of course, right now, obviously from my tone, I was super excited for this trilogy in particular. Very familiar with this trilogy, so I could be more hyped. But yeah, I'm excited for Eclipse, which I've heard, and the other one I've not heard of, so another very unclear yet clear video in the future. But yeah, again, thank you, Ruka, for spending some time with me.
Of course,
to
of course.
Watch this. And to re-listen to the songs, and yes, and really, thank you for the context. I wouldn't have known any of this without you.
You're welcome.
Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, the good stuff, and of course, subscribe to Ruka. And like, you know, the stuff is up here, anywhere, down there. You know where it is, and we'll see you in. Possibly the finale, maybe, but then I might react to future Dreamcatcher content with Ruka as well.
Right, because there's so many, like the B-side music videos, special clips, they've done so many covers. There's so much Dreamcatcher content, yes. Oh my gosh.
Yes, they have lots of content, so yes, I'm just gonna keep pumping out Dreamcatcher content, maybe sometime soon. But yeah, thanks for watching. Goodbye, everyone.
Bye-bye.